Okay, let's go. So, good morning. Good morning, everybody. I am now on my way to Arnhem/Oosterbeek. And there I'm going to participate in the Airborne walking route. If that's the correct pronunciation in English. But for my Dutch followers, it's the Airborne Wandeltocht. So it's a sort of a remembrance towards the British soldiers who fought in Oosterbeek and Arnhem during World War II, and especially during Market Garden. So it's like a big walk. You will walk the route that the soldiers walked during the war. So you can do a 10-kilometer walk, a 5-kilometer walk. You can do a 25-kilometer walk and a 40-kilometer walk, if I'm correct. And we, and I say we, because I'm now on my way to Otterlo to pick up my friend Nick. And then we are going to do the 25-kilometer walk. Yeah, and I'm not the best, in the best condition of my life. So I only go to the gym, lifting weights. So I'm not a big cardio guy. So probably today is going to be pretty rough for me and for Nick as well. So I'll bring you guys with me today, a sort of a extra vlog. Now this is a real vlog. Some people call my main channel a vlogging channel, but it's a documentary channel. It's not a vlog channel. Stop calling it a vlog channel. Well, anyways, we're on the way now. I'll bring you guys with me today, and I hope you will enjoy this little extra video on Sanific Extra.
Somewhere, Lord, we got folks in the street, ain't got nothing to heat, and the hobbies is keep on kicking them down. Lord, it's a damn shame what the world's gotten to.
Sweet home Alabama.
Let's go party.
I'm a Barbie girl in the Barbie world.
The nation's biggest
Hey!
Hello, followers of Sander Fieke History! Good morning!
How are you doing, mate?
Good.
Awesome.
Okay, we're going in style. In the BMW. Right? To Oosterbeek now. And yeah. Let's go!
Vanaf Apeldoorn kwam?
Apeldoorn, ja.
A lot of cars here, holy shit.
So, the buses, do we need to walk there?
No, with the bus.
Okay, there are buses, okay.
I'm here with my rear wheel drive in this wet field.
Oh man, this is gonna be fun. BMW, rear wheel drive. Probably gonna get stuck here. The funny thing is, on this field where we're standing right now, this was a supply drop. Area for the British to resupply the British airborne troops that were here in Oosterbeek. So that's pretty fun that we're parking here on the supply drop area. Holy shit, it's busy. I've never seen so many people here in Oosterbeek.
Wow,
that's crazy.
Ik blur mijn adres wel hoor.
Kijk, er staat erop. Yeah, buddy. We got our first. How do you say that in English? We got our first stamp?
Stamp.
Thank you. We got our first stamp. Dank u wel. Dank u wel. To be fair, this is really busy. It's one of the most busiest walking roads that they do events in the Netherlands. One of the busiest, and yeah, this is gonna be a hell of a day. Huh, Nick? Let's go. Let's start. Okay, here we go, man.
Let's go, man.
Let's do this. So Nick, how are you holding on? It's still good, it's still good. So we're now about 4 kilometers in and we still have like 20 to go. But feeling good, legs are warm, so yeah. So we just cut off the 10 kilometers, the people who do the 10 kilometer march and the 15 kilometer march. So, and we are doing the 25. So they went to the left behind us, and now we are going to do the 25. So wish us luck.
Yes,
thank you.
Thank you all.
I like sausage.
Oh, it's even dangerous on the streets. One guy almost got ran over by a bicycle. I'm not joking, he was screaming at him. But yeah, we're doing good. I think 8 kilometers in now, something like that. Not even half. And I'm beginning to feel my legs a little bit, but just eat sausage and then everything will be okay. So almost literally everywhere where you walk, especially on the route where we're walking now, you see houses that has flags from the 1st Airborne Division hanging. So, which is pretty cool because you see that the people, the civilians here in Oosterbeek and in Arnhem and the area around it, still the history lives pretty deep inside of them and they still want to pay and show their respects. So sometimes even if you go in the winter to Oosterbeek and you just drive around, you still see houses that have like the 1st Airborne flags hanging around, which is pretty cool to see. Yeah, this is it. Are you ashamed, Nick? Are you ashamed? Well, 8 kilometers now? 9 or 10? What is it? Some music on. Nick is ashamed of me now. He really wants to walk away from me, but yeah, he's too tired to do that probably.
20 to go.
Yeah, 20 to go. A little update. My legs are beginning to sore now. Especially here behind my leg. I'm feeling it. But yeah, we must keep going. They don't know me, son.
They don't know me, son!
Get it!
Who's gonna carry the boats, huh?
Who's gonna carry the boats in the logs?
Who's gonna carry the boats? So the fields behind me here, this is where a lot of the glider regiments landed during Market Garden. And it's not only this field here, but like behind the hedgerows, there are way more fields where they all landed. And yeah, it's a pretty beautiful sight. Like in this whole complete area, this is practically next to Wolfhazen. So that's where all the glider regiments landed. So we are now walking really close to Hilsum.
And this is also an area that they landed with the gliders and as well as paratroopers. And they made it now into a golf course. So I will show you on the Google Maps, you can see it now, that this is really, really big. And I will also mark the drop zones for you guys so you can now see it. Man, it's pretty cool to just walk here, doing like an airborne route march with so many people. And that they, all those people are doing it all for the boys that fought here for our freedom, which is, yeah, pretty cool. Our legs are pretty sore already. We're only like 12 kilometers in. But yeah, you know, we are not getting shot at, so the boys back then had it way harder than us, so we can't complain. So yeah, how are you holding up, Nick? Still good?
Very good. The sun is shining.
Well, it's very damp here, and yeah, that makes it a little bit harder. You sweat a little bit more. But yeah, we are keep on going. They don't know me, son!
They don't know me, son!
Get it!
Who's gonna carry the boats?
Who's gonna carry the boats and the logs?
Hilsum, we're getting closer. To increase the sodium. So now we're here at Hilsum, and you still can see some cool monuments here of yeah, what happened in the war during Market Garden. And now here's a British AT gun, which is pretty cool. It's en route, so just a quick stop here, and then we'll move on. So that's pretty dope, and now I'm moving up here.
Look at this.
Let's go! Get up, boy! Let's go!
Okay, let's go!
Hey, he's got a way better camera than I have. Way better camera! So, it isn't easy 25 kilometers when it's going uphill and downhill, uphill, downhill, uphill, downhill. The areas here in the Netherlands, in this part of the Netherlands, it's like only uphill and downhill structures here, which is very hard on the legs. Like if it was all flat, it was way easier to do. But like now we're walking uphill. And yeah, it's a little bit harder to do that than when it's all flat.
I'm a Barbie girl in a beautiful world.
Nick is done with me.
Terrible singer.
I'm a terrible singer. I'm singing Barbie Girl here. Because the people in front of us have a audio box playing Barbie Girl. I don't know if you can hear it, but...
Oh, I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. Life in plastic. It's fantastic. Undress me everywhere. Imagination. Life is your creation.
Still really cool that you see all the flags just hanging on the houses. Still makes me proud of my country. Yeah, is your right leg hurting, Nick?
It is what it is.
Let's go, man. It is what it is.
Shit happens.
Let's go. Yeah, the legs are beginning to hurt pretty bad now. And we're just over half of the whole route, and we have a checkup in front of us there. So luckily it's only sore legs, but you know, it's a little bit annoying.
How long?
Voorzichtig met die auto's achter je als je wil.
We gaan onze best doen.
Want ik vind dat gedoe met die auto's hier zo eng.
Ja, zo eng, hè? Okay. Okay, we just had a checkup. We got stamped on the paper, and then now it's off to the last one. Easy. Who said 25 kilometers is hard?
Who got the boats?
Who's gonna carry the boats, huh?
Who's gonna carry the boats and the logs?
They don't know me, son.
They don't know me, son.
Still going strong. Still going strong. My legs hurt, but we're still gonna go. It's easy. Nick also has some sore legs.
One leg.
Only one leg. Yeah, it's easy. 25 is nothing. We brush it off like it's nothing. And we just entered Doorwerth. We are close to Oosterbeek. I think it's around 6 kilometers now. Something like that. So we must keep going on. We must keep moving. I underestimated it a little bit. I think I'm not the only one who underestimated it. But no, it's cool. Just walk with sore legs. Like David Goggins always says, it's just sore legs, you know. Okay, we took a minute rest just to put the shoes off and back on. So Nick said that was a good idea. So now let's go to the finish. You doing good, Nick? Yeah? Still doable? Okay, it's getting pretty tough now. It's all downhill from here, which doesn't make it easier. Makes it very hard now, but keep on marching on. Next time I will train for this type of stuff. Oh, nice, the Polish flag as well. Oh, I don't know if you could see it, but there was also a Polish flag on that house there, which is pretty cool because the Polish don't get the recognition often that they deserve while we're here during Market Garden. So yeah, it's pretty cool to see a Polish flag hang on that house there. If you walk on straight asphalt, it's pretty doable, it's okay. But if you walk on paths like this, it's killing your legs, it's crazy. Nick is he's really struggling. We're almost there. I think with 2 to 3 kilometers then we're there. So it's probably 1.5 miles. And then we're finished. Well, then we did it. Go on, Nick. It's crazy how like the pain. Wow, my legs. It's been a while since I felt my legs like this. Nick is now going to the bathroom. I'm waiting here for him. But you got a pretty nice view. From this angle. And a lot of people are still walking. A lot of people are now resting. And the 10 kilometer and the 15 kilometer are now intertwining with each other again. So everybody goes through the same route now towards the finish. So yeah, pretty done with it. Maybe 3 kilometers to go, a little bit less, and then yeah, and then the finish. So how are your legs? Sore?
You're the best.
Yeah, he's trying to be tough on camera, but behind the carriage, like, oh, my legs!
Behind the scenes.
Yeah, behind the scenes. So just resting here for 2 minutes and then ride on. And we're marching again to the finish line. Pretty close now. A few kilometers. Kijk. Nou, super.
Dank je wel.
And of course, at the end, it's uphill again. Come on, Nick, you're almost there. Oh man, the struggle is getting more real and real. Going down, pretty steep. It hurts at the back of your legs when you go down like this. I could use a cart like that. Almost there, buddy.
Klaus to the finish.
Klaus to the finish, yeah. We're back in Oosterbeek. Nice. So, just to give you a little bit of a more perspective on this walk, this is what my app data says on my phone. So it says that we've been walking for almost 5 hours now, and we walked for like 24 kilometers. So 11 minutes for 1 kilometer average. So yeah, 5 hours of constant walking. We didn't even stop once. Yeah, once for like 2 minutes when we were sitting down in the grass, but the rest, yeah, it was just straight on walking. Nick is done. He wants to go home. No, it's after we finish this, we could say that we're proud of ourselves. Lekker man! Okay, so we're walking now near the old church. What we in the Netherlands call the Oude Kerk. And this is the last part of the pocket where the British soldiers were in during Operation Market Garden. So this was the last remaining sector that the British held and occupied before the Germans all stormed in. And yeah, the thing is, the side of the church, which is pretty cool to see, I will show you that now, is completely peppered with a lot of bullet holes. So I'll show you that now with that picture. But yeah, oh, how many time left? How much left? Maybe 10 minutes, 20 minutes or so, and we're at the finish. So here, this is the old church. Pretty busy still, but almost there. Almost there. So the streets where we are going to walk now, there's a lot of pictures taken here during World War II. And you've probably seen on my main channel all the then and now pictures. If not, then I would recommend you guys to check it out. I have a lot of short videos on my other YouTube channel, my main channel, that shows a lot of those pictures and the current sights today. So we're now walking down a street which has some amazing pictures of a King Tiger tank who was in here. So they got shot by a Piat grenade by the British here in this pocket. And yeah, it's pretty cool that everybody is walking around there. And not a lot of people will see the pictures, or they know what happened here. Of course they know the stories, but not like the specific details. So we're walking down here, and here, even this fence, if I can show you, here, all has battle damage. You see that? It's completely shot, which is pretty cool that you can still see a lot of battle damage here in the town of Oosterbeek. So still a few kilometers to go and then we're done. I keep saying that, but still, it's true. There are so many pictures taken here in this street. So here, I will show you those short videos now. But it's pretty cool, because yeah, the war here was photographed a lot. I don't know if you can hear me by the music, but yeah, this street has so many photos, it's insane. And to show you that, I will put some photos now on the screen so you can see that. It's only up and down, uphill, downhill, uphill, downhill. Yeah. It's crazy. Man, I will be so happy when I reach the finish. almost done, Nick. We're almost there.
Man, it's been crazy. My legs, I never felt my legs like this. I'm never, ever, like I said before, going to do this untrained. Before I need to prepare more for this type of stuff. Because my legs hurt, man. It's crazy. But we almost made it.
It's almost the finish. Almost there, Nick.
Almost there. Nick,
I can see the finish line.
We're almost there. Come on. Who's gonna carry the boats? Yes. There it is. The finish line. Wow, what a challenge.
I'm glad we did this.
You're not so happy. Yeah. There is he, Nick. Here we are, Nick. The finish line.
High five!
Let's go! Yeah, the finish line! There we go! Nice! And now I got another camera to film other people. Hey! We did it, bruv. Now we have to walk 5 kilometers back to the car. We did it. Fuck yeah. 25 kilometers. Holy hell. Oh, my legs, man. It's crazy. Nice. Yes. Yes. Have it gedaan. Fucking did it. Okay, we just finished walking and look at this. It took us 5 hours and 44 minutes. We walked 27.2 kilometers and we did it in average like 12 minutes per kilometer, which is crazy. Untrained, not prepared, just yeah, we just did it and we made it. So now we're going to collect the medal. And then we are heading home.
Yeah.
Kijk.
Ja, top, dankjewel.
Super. Krijg geen. Oh, die kan je natuurlijk op die andere doen, hè? There's the car, Nick. 10 meters to go. Oh. And we made it. Oh, finally. And we're back in the car after 6 hours, even more, 6 hours and 15 minutes of constantly walking.
We only took a break for like 2 minutes somewhere, and we are exhausted. But we made it, we did it. We got the medal, the piece of the medal, and yeah, we're going home now. I hope you guys enjoyed this different type of video, and this is on Sandvika Extra. So yeah, check out my main channel as well, because there I do my main content. And I want to thank Nick. Hey, we did it, man. Awesome. So see you guys later. I wanted to say in the next episode, but yeah, I'll see you guys later. Salute. I'm completely exhausted. Holy shit.